By faith we see the hand of God. In the line of creation's grand design. In the lives of those who prove his faithfulness. Who walk by faith and not by sight.
Good morning and welcome to the Chester ARP Church Devotional Podcast. I'm Clint Davis, your host. Thank you for joining us. It's Wednesday, and that means we have completed, for the most part, the hardest part of the week, in my opinion. Mondays and Tuesdays are most difficult. Wednesday begins the downward slide toward the weekend. We look forward to finishing up our work week together. But as we turn our attention this morning to the Psalms, we'll turn our attention to Psalm 137. Interesting note about Psalm 137, and one of the study Bibles that I have on my shelf says this, that the theme of this psalm is that a person in exile weeps over the bitterness of captivity. And then it makes this comment, our sorrow can make it difficult to imagine singing joyful songs again. I find that to be a remarkable and interesting statement about Psalm 137, given that Psalm 137 naturally follows after Psalm 136. If you were with us yesterday, you know that Psalm 136 is a psalm where the chorus of God and His people ring out that the love of God endures forever. And there are times in our lives where we joyfully sing that wonderful truth. And then there are times when it is hard to sing that joyful truth. In fact, it's hard to see that our God is a God of steadfast love. It's hard to see where God loves us at all when we realize and struggle through the sufferings and the difficulties of our lives. And the people of Israel sat on the rivers of Babylon while they were in captivity and cried over the glory of the days gone by, the days when they had opportunity to go to the temple in Jerusalem, days when they had the opportunity to listen to the priests and the prophets, days when they had the opportunity to gather together to worship God, days when they lived in freedom to do that. They were carried off into captivity into the land of Babylon, and they cried over the loss that they had suffered. And sometimes that is true for you and me, is it not? Sometimes our circumstances and the sufferings of our lives make it difficult for us to see the steadfast love of God. And the only hope we have during those times is to sit down and weep, is to cry out to our God and to weep and to express our sorrow and our frustration. And so this is what Psalm 137 is about. It's about remembering that God is a God who cares for His people, but also being willing to express our sorrow and our grief to Him and before Him, and recognizing that that emotion of sadness and grief comes from Him and requires us and challenges us to think more faithfully about Him and to rest in Him more fully. So here is Psalm 137. By the waters of Babylon, there we sat down and wept. When we remembered Zion, on the willows there we hung up our lyres. For there our captives required of us songs, and our tormentors myrrh, saying, sing us one of those songs of Zion. How shall we sing the Lord's song in a foreign land? If I forget you, O Jerusalem, let my right hand forget its skill. Let my tongue stick to the root of my mouth. If I do not remember you, if I do not set Jerusalem above my highest joy. Remember, O Lord, against the Edomites, the day of Jerusalem. How they said, lay it bare, O down to its foundation. O daughter of Babylon, doomed to be destroyed. Blessed shall he be who repays you with what you have done to us. Blessed shall he be who takes your little ones and dashes them against the rock. It's a psalm we're crying out in grief, but also asking God to move and bring judgment on the people of Babylon. The word Babylon, the theme of Babylon, appears later on in the Bible in Revelation chapter 19. And Babylon is known as the dwelling place of Satan. And we have wonderful hope today that that Jerusalem, the city of God, has once again risen through the person of Jesus Christ, and you and I will rest in its throne, in its place forever, and sitting with Him while those in Babylon will be destroyed by his hand as he returns in glory and victory. You guys be encouraged today. Though God may appear to be distant, there's hope because Christ has risen from the dead. Take care. God bless you. See you tomorrow.